question is, does one bad apple spoil the whole bunch? There's songs that tell you it won't. Given time, it sure will if we look at it from a post-harvest point of view. You've got two bushels of peaches here. One bushel of peaches actually has a problem in it. It is destroying the whole group in here. On the other side, you've got peaches that do not have that particular problem, and they look quite healthy. In Florida, they sell a lot of strawberries. You all know you buy a box of strawberries. If you let it sit around for a week in your refrigerator when you come back, you've got one fungal mass all over the place. It's just horrible looking. You have to be able to consume them fairly quickly. When we're dealing with fleshy type materials, some of these things are prone to be able to store for a long period of time. Some of them must be consumed rather quickly. Those things that need to be consumed rather quickly, we often go out and either can or freeze or pickle. Those things that can be stored for a long period of time, like some of the grains, if you have the proper environmental conditions, can be stored for quite some time before something has to happen to them. When you look at these, post-harvest becomes a very important part on how we store these materials. This is corn grain. Corn grain has a problem with Aspergillus flavus, as does peanuts. Aspergillus flavus produces a material called aflatoxin. Aflatoxin can do many different things, including trigger spontaneous abortion in animals. It is toxic to certain birds. It is an all-around problem. This material actually infects the plant at a pre-harvest stage in the field. If you were to take these ears, you leave the ears on them and you put them in a corn crib somewhere, they will infect other ears. When you harvest material, one of the first things you have to do is get the moisture level down to a point so that things like this can't grow on it. If they have a grain that they know might have been exposed to something like this, rather than let it stay around, process it right away. It should not be a problem. This is a post-harvest or a storage-type material. Many times when they store stuff, they have to make sure that everything is dried down. They have to make sure that all of the conditions are proper inside of the storage area to make sure that we don't have problems. This is a special type of plant disease. We've got an orange. That particular orange has got a penicillium on it. A lot of penicilliums are very important post-harvest materials. That will spread out. That will infect the rest of them. When you have things, you have to make sure that things are harvested properly and stored properly. This is a peach. We've got a lot of stuff that we go out and we bring home. If you don't eat it in the proper time period, which means you really should be consuming it within 3 or 4 days of the time you bring fresh fruit home, it will start to mold over, and the next thing you know is you've got this, especially if you kept it around for a couple of weeks. We saw the one on the banana, which is the anthracnose. This is the peach from a lateral view. You could still cut this peach in the middle and remove the bottom part and consume that if it hasn't been affected. There are a lot of different things that we could look at as far as these materials go. You have to be very careful with them. This is an apple with penicillium on the outside. You can see how this apple has just really been liquefied, and it's really nasty looking. If this were to happen in something like a packing plant, this type of apple would go into the manufacturing of vinegar. They wouldn't necessarily throw it out. You can still use it to make vinegar. We do have post-harvest diseases like that. When we look at post-harvest diseases, these are very important. These are directly affecting our food supply. What you have to be very careful with is when you get material back and you're going to use it for food, you need to watch what you've got to make sure that it is being properly utilized.